Welcome to Beyond the Data. I'm Dr. Phoebe Thorpe, and here with me today is Dr. Bobbi Pritt from the Mayo Clinic. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Our session today is about tick-borne diseases. We heard a lot of good information about tick-borne diseases. Can you share some of the highlights that you think people should know about tick-borne diseases?
Sure, absolutely. Well, I think first it's important to know that human-biting ticks are found in many parts of the United States, and they can transmit through their bite a number of bacteria, viruses, and parasites. So one of the most important messages I have for people is to know what ticks are in your area and what diseases, and then know what the major symptoms of those diseases are so they can keep but watch out for them. The CDC has some excellent information, including some maps that show the distribution of the major human biting ticks and the diseases they carry, so that's a good resource. The other thing that I think is important for the general public is that if they're feeling ill and they go to their doctor, they should mention if they've had a recent tick bite, because that's important and the physician can use that information to help determine what's causing their illness.
Mm-hmm. And so these tick-borne diseases, they're carried by ticks, so avoiding ticks is important.
It's pretty important,
that's right.
Yeah.
So what can people do to avoid being bitten by ticks?
Yeah, that's a great question, because prevention is key. So at Mayo Clinic, we've developed the ABCs of tick bite prevention. So it's pretty straightforward. A is avoid. You want to avoid the areas where ticks are found, which is in tall grasses, in bushes, leaf litter. And the ticks can't fly, but they can climb up on vegetation and grab onto you when you walk by. So something simple, just like when you're in the middle of a path, avoiding the edges where the tall grasses are, mm-hmm. that could help prevent mm-hmm. tick exposure. So that's A. Now B is bug spray. When you're going to be outside, you are in some situations going to be exposed to ticks. You can't help it. You want to be out in the great outdoors. So taking some simple measures like using bug spray, specifically a product that has 20 to 30% DEET. Mm-hmm. You could also use a product with picaridin. You can spray permethrin directly on your clothing. Mm-hmm. And that takes me to C, which is clothing. So if it's not too hot and you can stand it, wearing long sleeves, wearing long pants, that will provide less opportunity, less skin for the ticks to attach and bite. Mm-hmm. Now, all of these are great measures, but when you come in from outside, it's really important to do that tick check. Mm-hmm. Check yourself, check your family, and check your pets as well.
Yeah, that's the other thing. And showering mm-hmm. is another thing that I had heard was good, too.
Showering's really good because you're more likely to see ticks and catch them if they're on your scalp or other parts of your body you may forget to check otherwise.
Yeah, and then what should you do if you find a tick on you?
Yeah, good question. So don't panic. That's probably the first thing. But you want to remove it as quickly as possible. So the best way to do that is using fine tip tweezers. Mm-hmm. And if these are the tweezers, if you have a tick on you, you basically want to get as close to the skin as possible, grasp firmly, and then just pull it out in a smooth, continuous motion. You don't want to twist. You don't want to squeeze the tick, because that may cause it to regurgitate some of its stomach contents into your skin, and that may transmit diseases. You also want to avoid folklore remedies like putting petroleum jelly on the tick or burning the tick with a match or a lighter, because that could just actually damage your skin, damage the tick, and maybe even increase the likelihood of getting infection.
Mm-hmm. And then if they find the tick, should they bring it into their doctor? Are there any recommendations about that?
Yeah, you can, depending on what area of the country you live in, if Lyme disease is prevalent and present in a large amount, then if the tick has been attached for 36 hours or more, and you can tell that by how swollen it is, how mm-hmm. engorged, then it is a good idea to take the tick, bring it to your doctor. In some situations, your doctor may prescribe antibiotics to prevent Lyme disease.
Okay, so it just depends on
where you are. It never hurts to put the tick in a Ziploc bag, and you can just hold on to it in case you need it.
Yeah. In the session today, there was a reminder about treating with starting doxy immediately mm-hmm. if you suspect Rocky Mountain spotted fever. What are some of the other things that healthcare providers should keep in mind if they are treating somebody with a tick-borne disease mm-hmm. or suspect one?
Sure. Well, probably an important thing to know is that there can be co-infections. So the patient may not be infected with just one thing, but may have two organisms and have two infections. So when ordering tests and considering whether the patient needs treatment, the physician needs to think of what that patient may have. It may not just be Lyme disease, but the patient may have anaplasmosis or lickiosis. There's different different Borrelia species, and there's some viruses too.
Mm-hmm. And all of those need to be, you need to keep
considered
those in mind
in the
if
differential.
You're thinking of it. Sure,
exactly.
Sure. And then we also heard some about public health efforts that are being done.
Yeah. Can
you tell us a little bit about the public health efforts that are being done for tick-borne diseases?
Well, I think the public health plays such a key role in providing education to the public, but also to the physicians that are seeing the patients and to the nurses and the other members of the healthcare team. So we all need to work together as part of a multidisciplinary team so that we have all of the right information, treatment algorithms, testing, and we're all familiar with what diseases are circulating in our areas.
Mm-hmm. And I know CDC recently updated their treatment guidelines for tick-borne diseases.
Mm-hmm. That's a great resource. I always refer patients there if they want more information.
Mm-hmm. And then you mentioned the maps that are available for telling people where the diseases are.
Mm-hmm.
I bet that's helpful too.
Extremely.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you very much for joining us.
Oh, thank you.
And thank you for joining us for Beyond the Data. See you next time.